Good afternoon all. Yesterday lecture we had discussed with meat of the chapter number 1, reproduction in an organism. Today we will discuss a few points, and within the next lecture I will complete the meat of this chapter. And here very little bit portion of neat portion is there, and chapter is very small, so within the next lecture I will complete this one. Fine, so let's continue with the next topic. As the fungi and pteridophyta. Okay, in algae, fungi, bryophyta and pteridophyta, fragmentation is common. So in these all plants, fragmentation is very common. Fine, algae, fungi, bryophytes and pteridophytes. Whereas in protista, fission and fragmentation is very common. I told you that in protista you considered protozoa, majority protozoa, and here amoeba, paramecium, and we considered plasmodium. Okay, in that multiple fission is very common, as well as binary fission also. Many flatworms know that the flatworms belonging to platyhelminths. Shows fragmentation. Here we say that example platyhelminths, flatworm in the planaria. I told to you that in Hydra, planaria and starfish. So Hydra belonging to Coelenterata, planaria belonging to flatworm, that is platyhelminth, and echinodermata in that starfish. These three animals shows fragmentation. So many of the platforms here, liver fluke, fine. In that platyhelminth shows the fragmentation just like a planaria. Okay, in higher plants, I told to you that in plants asexual reproduction wall cannot be used there. So in higher plants, instead of asexual reproduction we say that vegetative propagation. So in higher plants, asexual reproduction is also known as in higher plants, the asexual reproduction is known as vegetative propagation. And here in vegetative propagation, majorly from the body parts, root, stem or leaf, like that. And some parts of it, okay, propagulate together and form the new plant. So vegetative propagation is of two types. Natural vegetative propagation and artificial vegetative propagation. Now here in natural vegetative propagation, we use the natural method. The part of the stem, root or leaf or any part of the plant useful for asexual reproduction, I mean to say vegetative propagation, and by artificially also we can produce the new plant also. Fine? Okay, so here in higher plants, the asexual reproduction is also known as vegetative propagation and is of two types, natural and artificial. Let us discuss with the next topic, natural vegetative propagation in higher plants. By the part of the root, stem or leaf, naturally the plant is propagated. Fine. Let us discuss the different parts. First is root. By root or the adventitious root or the part of the root, the plant is vegetative propagated. Here examples are guava, sweet potato, dahlia, asparagus. Actually asparagus racemosus is a medicinal plant also known as shatavari. In that vegetative propagation is seen by roots. Now through the stem, here parts of the stem are there. underground stem. So in stem few parts are there. Yes, generally we say that stem is an aerial part. Stem is an aerial part, but in some plant underground stem is there, and in some plant aerial stem is there. Barabar. So here underground stem. So the stem is underground and useful for vegetative propagation. Example, onion. Garlic, crocus, colocasia, and potato. Here, if one thing you know that in potato, I is there. Actually, potato is known scientifically known as Solanum tuberosum. Solanum tuberosum, the potato, and here it is an example of tuber. On the potato, pits are there. So that pit is known as eye of the potato, and this eye of the potato is nothing but axillary bud. So here underground stem perform the function. Now subaerial stem. Subaerial stem means the half of the stem is underground and half of the stem is aerial, above ground, is known as subaerial stem. So first is underground stem means the ground is the stem is totally under the ground. So here half of the stem is there in the ground and half of the stem is outside. So here few examples are there. Icornia crescipis. In this chapter we had discussed that Icornia crescipis is known as terror of Bengal, is known as Jalkumbhi, as well as Pistia known as Jalshrukhla. So Icornia and Pistia are aquatic plants. So here the lower part of the stem consists the branches. So that branches run parallel to the water surface, and the tip of the branch can coming in contact with the water surface. The new plant is developed. It is known as offset. So offset is always there in aquatic plant. Next is grass. Oxalis and Hydrolepis. sorry, hydrocotyle. Grass, here are two types of the grass, dub grass and durva grass. Oxalis is abuti and hydrocotyle is nothing but brahmi. So here these are terrestrial plants. So here the lower part of the stem, the branch is run parallel to the ground level, whereas here the lower branch of the stem run parallel to the water surface. So here the branch of the stem run parallel to the ground. The tip of the branch can coming in contact with the soil and produce the new plant. This is known as runner. Okay. Next, strawberry and nephrolepis. Nephrolepis, also known as Hansraj. So in strawberry and nephrolepis, the lower branch run obliquely to the ground level and the tip of the branch can coming in contact with the soil and produce the new plant. That procedure is known as stolon. Okay, and the last one is mint. Here the lowest branch of the stem run parallel to the underground level, just inside the soil it run parallel to the ground level. So here parallel to the water surface above the ground, parallel to the soil surface above the ground, obliquely to the soil surface, and here under the soil, parallel to the soil surface, mint in that suckers. So in this mint, this type of the vegetative propagation known as sucker. So in this way, subaerial stem, okay, this type of the vegetative propagation is seen. So now underground, subaerial, and now we take it as a aerial stem. Totally at the ground level. Fragments of opuntia. Opuntia is thorny plant and this is xerophytic plant. You know that in Opuntia, the leaves are very less in number. It is grown in the xerophytic region in desert. So, to cope up with the stressful condition, this Opuntia fall off all the leaves. As a result, leaves are not there. So there is no chance of photosynthesis. So here what happened? The stem become greenish in color. It consists of chlorophyll and perform photosynthesis. But prevent the grazing from the animals. The Opuntia consists thorns on the stem. Okay, so this is known as phylloclade. In Opuntia, phylloclade. We have discussed this in 5th chapter of 11th standard. So in fragments of the Opuntia and many cactus plants, some parts coming in contact with the soil to produce the new plant. Okay, so this is about the aerial part of the stem. Now, this is about the stem. We are talking about the leaves. Through leaves, how the vegetative propagation occurs. Let's see the examples. Through leaves, fan footing or perna footing, whatever you say. So here in bryophyllum, the wall leaf margin, on the wall leaf margin, small leaf buds are produced. When you implant this leaf in the soil, from each and every leaf bud, new plant is cultivated, new plant is developed. So in Telanchoe as well as Adiantum, that is walking fern, in this also we see the same type of it. So these are the examples of vegetative propagation by leaves. Now the fourth one and last, that is bulbil. Actually, bulbil is a one type of vegetative propagation in which the food storage is there. Actually, here we can form the heading like that food storage and reproduction. So some part of the plant can store the food, it becomes heavy in weight. Follow from the plant, coming in contact with the soil, and then new plant is developed. Okay, so here in this bulbil, oxalis, Okay. Here examples are Oxalis, Allium sativum. Allium sativum, also known as garlic. Dioscorea sinuleta, known as kanak. K-A-N-A-K. Dioscorea sinuleta. So in these three plants, the axillary bud stores the food. You know that the angle between stem and leaf, or you say that stem and petiole, that angle is known as axil, and it consists axillary bud. So this axillary bud stores the food, become heavy in weight, and then follow from the parental plant, and from that new plant is developed. Where is you think about the agave? So agave, that is ramban. The floral bud stores the food, and the explanation is same, just like above one. Fine. So in this bulbil, this many examples are there. So this is about the natural method. Okay. Natural vegetative propagation method in plants. So this is about this thing. So I hope you understand this. So this many examples are present in the natural one. Let us discuss with the artificial method. First, artificial method. In that first, by usage of the special vegetative parts. Little bit portion to know that. Here, few examples are root tuber. It is majorly seen in sweet potato and dahlia. Okay. So, sweet potato and dahlia. Yes, this is there in the root also. Fine. So artificially we will take the small part. Artificial method in that we will take the small part of the root, stem or leaf, then implant it in the soil and we propagate the plant. So root tuber in the sweet potato, you know that adventitious roots. Okay, so in dahlia also corn. The two examples are there, crocus and colocasia. Okay, so you know that corn in that one node stores the food and become fleshy. So here in crocus and colocasia, So we take the part of the root, and then next is bulb. Examples: onion and garlic. Yes, you know that if you cut the upper part, onion in that leaf base, onion and garlic in that leaf base stores the food and become fleshy. So from that, new plant is vegetative propagated. Part of the rhizome. So here, part of the rhizome in that ginger. Mango ginger, turmeric and banana. Okay, so from this we can propagate it. Stem tuber. Here the example is potato, in that we have discussed that earlier, that in potato, the eye of the potato, it is an axillary bud. Fine. So that axillary bud, the pit from the bud, and it is implanted in the soil and producing new plant. And then last one is bulbil in that pineapple. So these all are the examples of the usage of the special vegetative parts by artificial method. Now here, in 10th standard, you had studied the different artificial methods also, cutting, layering and grafting, if you have remembered. So it is not given in the textbook, the artificial method, cutting, layering and grafting. Now let us discuss with this. So second is cutting. The root, the part of the root, stem or leaf can be cut in the small fragments, and then we form the new plant from it. Okay, so that method is known as cutting. So here in few examples we say, see, remember here I will tell you the name of the plant in which root parts can be taken. So blackberry, raspberry, tamarind known as imli, and lemon. Lemon, scientific name Citrus limon. So blackberry, raspberry, tamarind, that is imli, and lemon. In this, all these plants, we take these small parts of the root, small fragment of the root, and then implant in the soil, we form these plants. Okay, then write about the stem. So in stem, examples of the plant. Rose, clerodendron, durantia, citrus, tea, coffee, bougainvillea, spectabilis known as bougainvillea, and coca. So here, in this old plants, we take the part of the stem, and that small part of the stem can be implanted in the soil, we form the new plant. But here remember that cultivate this all the plants, to cultivate the stem fragment, we add NAA. You know that NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, and IBA, indole butyric acid, in the soil. It is the type of auxin. It is the growth promoter hormone. We add the soil, this hormone into the soil, and then with the help of this we form the plant rapidly. Now we will discuss the next part, that is layering. So cutting in that, the small fragment of the root, stem and leaf can be taken and form the new plant. So now the next is layering. Remember here, in layering, majority what we can do, the lowermost branch of the plant can be now fixed in the soil artificially. By dung or by soil particles, by sand, we can pressurize it and implant in the soil and allow it to grow the adventitious root. Wait for the time up to where it forms the adventitious roots, and then when the branch is there in the soil, it forms the adventitious root, then we cut this branch from the main plant, and this plant leaf acts as a leaf as an independent plant. Fine. So this is known as layering. So layering can be done in cherry, Jasmine. Grapevine. Grapevine, gooseberry, currant, lychee, pomegranate, guava, orange and lemon. Etc. Fine. So in all these plants, layering can be done. So again, understand that how the layering can be done. The lowermost branch of the plant can be now pressurized and fixed in the soil artificially. Allow it to grow the adventitious roots. Wait for this time. Cut this branch from the parental main plant and then allow it to live independent life. Fine? So this is layering. Now the next point is grafting. Cutting, layering and grafting. It is the most common artificial method. It is successfully done where roots and its parts are not properly developed. As well as this method is successful where the plant has active cambium. Grafting is a very common artificial method, and here it is successfully done where the roots and its parts are not properly developed there in plants, as well as the cambium is activated at this part. We will successfully grafting. Okay, and here you know that two plants are there, stalk and scion. The plant can be taken as a model. The plant we take as a model known as stalk, and the part of the plant can be selected for implantation known as scion. So here two words you know very well: stalk and Sion. Okay? So here, grafting up to that, I can stop right now. Hope you understood this much portion. Fine. So, in next lecture, I will explain the types of grafting, and then we will carry on towards the next sexual reproduction part. Fine. Hope you understand this very well. Thank you very much to all.